Feast of Weeks, Part 2. The first century church was mainly Jewish. The last century church will be mainly Gentile. This explains Paul's statement that the blessings of God were to the Jew first and also the Gentiles. Let's look at symbols and what they represent. Symbol, a grain of wheat. Represents the Messiah, John 12:23-24. Symbol, two loaves with leaven, Leviticus 23:15-17. Represents Jewish and Gentile believers in Messiah. Symbol, as the wheat is beaten and refined as fine flour, Leviticus 23:17. Represents Messiah beaten, sifted, and crushed, Isaiah 28:28, 52:14, and 53:1-6. Symbol, harvest salvation, represents outpouring of the Holy Spirit. The two loaves were huge. Ye shall bring out of your habitations two wave loaves of 2/10 deals. They shall be of fine flour, and they shall be baked with leaven. They are the first fruits unto the Lord. Leviticus 23:17. An ephah is a measure of Egyptian origin and contained 2 omars. An omar is about 2 quarts. So it would be approximately 4 quarts of flour. 4 quarts of 4 cups each is about 16 cups of fine flour. This would make the loaves approximately 12 inches by 21 inches long by 3 inches deep. The followers of the Messiah obtained a mission through the dramatic descent of the Holy Spirit. From the moment of birth, this community, the early church, intended itself not a new religion, but rather an awakening movement within Judaism. The church members continued to observe the Jewish laws and worshipped regularly in the temple. What distinguished them from other Jews was their conviction that Jesus, as the promised Messiah, would appear to restore the kingdom of Israel. There are many names for the Feast of Weeks. It is identified in the Old Testament as the Feast of Weeks, Exodus 34:22, and the Feast of Harvest, Exodus 23:16. As explained in the previous chapter, this feast is referred to as latter first fruits. The Hebrew name is Shavuot, pronounced Sha-Vu-Ote. The Greek name Pentecost is only found in the New Testament, Acts 2:1. Pentecost is a major festival and has a dual significance, historical and agricultural. Just as Passover and Tabernacles, unlike Passover and Tabernacles, it is observed for only 2 days, only one in the Reform movement. Pentecost marks the end of barley harvest and the beginning of wheat harvest. Counting the days from the second day of Passover to Pentecost is called the counting of Omar. The cutting of the Omar, the new barley, marked the beginning of the counting period. On the 50th day, Pentecost is observed. Pentecost is a Greek word meaning 50th. Again, let's look at the first Pentecost and Pentecost after Christ. The first Pentecost, the commandments were given. After Christ, the Holy Spirit given. The first Pentecost, 50 days from the crossing of the Red Sea. After Christ, 50 days from the resurrection of Christ. First, law of Yahweh written in stone. After Christ, law of Yahweh written on our hearts. First Pentecost, 3,000 slain. After Christ, 3,000 received salvation. First Pentecost, the letter of the law. After Christ, the spirit of the law. Pentecost is considered the closing festival of Passover season. Exodus 34:22, Leviticus 23:15, and Deuteronomy 16:9-10. It is also referred to as the Day of the Congregation, Deuteronomy 18:16. Another name is Atzeret, meaning stop or cease or conclusion of 7 weeks of counting. Pentecost is the only festival for which no specific date is given in the Bible. Rather, the people were instructed to count 7 weeks from the morrow of the Sabbath, from the day that ye brought the sheaf, Omer, of the wave offering in Leviticus 23:15. It is the successful conclusion of the first wheat growing season and the anniversary celebration of the giving of the Torah on Mount Sinai. It is a celebration to reawaken and strengthen personal relationships with God by rededication to the observance and the study of the Torah, the most precious heritage. When Yahweh, God, revealed himself on Mount Sinai, his people heard his voice proclaiming the Ten Commandments. Then the Israelites pledged their allegiance to Yahweh by saying, "All that the Lord hath said will we do and be obedient." Exodus 24:7. Passover freed God's people physically from bondage, but the giving of the Torah on Shavuot redeemed us spiritually from our bondage to idolatry and immorality. The Torah contains the 5 books of Moses, the prophets, and the writings. When is the Feast of Weeks? On the Jewish calendar, Sivan, 50 days after first fruits. Our calendar, May, June. Spring or fall feast? It's a spring feast. Scripture, Exodus 34:33, Leviticus 23:15-16. Deuteronomy 16:10-16, 2 Chronicles 8:13. Significance, weeks, Shavuot, also known as Pentecost, speaks of origination, symbolizes Jesus giving us the gift of the Holy Spirit, which inaugurated the New Covenant and Church Age. This concludes our study of the Feast of Weeks.